Welcome back to Leagues 3, but we fight. The rules are simple. Lilratbags and myself have 4 hours to prepare, and then we fight. The loser has to out their most expensive item. Last episode, I lost the fight and my fire staff, and step one was to get that back. This 4 hours in Leagues has a goal that will change everything. To progress with magic, we need a consistent supply of Chaos Runes, and with Chaos Runes, I can unlock some key pieces of content that are gonna allow me to drop Lilratbags faster than Internet Explorer can remind you to change to the default browser. Chaos Runes are just the key, however, and not the lock. Another part of the plan is unlocking melee, so the secondary objective is gonna be completing enough tasks to unlock melee stats and gear. See, Lilratbags has gone down the rigorous ranging route, and well, melee beats range. Let's dive in. Chaos Runes is simple. Level up my mining to 30, and then get runecrafting to 35, and use the abyss to acquire the rest. Mining was first, and to do this I would complete the Devious Doric's quest. Once I cleared it, the quest rewarded me of 10,400 mining experience and 30 mining. It was now time for the runecrafting guide. I can now mine pure essence, which means I can benefit from the outlandish Urania Alta. And I did a few runs there and got 35 runecrafting. Time to hit the abyss. The Abyss is home to some of the most efficient runecrafting runs, and it can access all the altars, but the place is silently swarming with deranged demons, and being a low level, entering this place would be really risky. However, at the Urania Altar, I did get some war runes, so I have an emergency teleport out. It was time to craft the first set of Chaos Runes. The first attempt was a farcical failure. The demons were too strong, and I needed some armor, so I set off with a bountiful birth up and killed some gaudy guards out of the games room until I got a merciless mithril plate body. Then, I set off once again. With that, we have mission success. A supply line has been established. It is now time to get some real progress in Leagues. My initial escapade into the alluring abyss taught me one thing. Defense was not a stat to be ignored. So I decided to smash out the quest, What Lies Below. And finishing that quest rewarded me with 49 runecrafting and 35 defense, as well as the Beacon Ring, which is a really powerful early game ring, providing a solid magic bonus. After this, I smashed out some easy tasks in the wilderness to get my sage's renown, and then crafted a heap of Chaos Runes. All these unlocks would allow me to do one particular thing. Kill lava dragons. Lava dragons can be safe spotted and easily taken down with the firebolt spell. And they drop dragon bones, which can be offered at the Chaos Altar to level my prayer at a ridiculous rate. That isn't even the best part though. Lava dragons drop a range of items that I need. I just need to get lucky though. It sounds perfect, but there's one drawback. They are in the deep wilderness, which puts me at risk of being killed by the players. And, well, if we want to beat Lilratbags, we need to get that gear. First run was completely dry. The only drop that we got was of any use was some rune darts and bolts, which I turned into GP. However, I did get my magic level to 53. It was now time to reprovision and have a break from the wilderness. It was now time to start unlocking some things. Starting off, I would unlock the aggravating attack skill. From here, I started the Grand Tree quest and took out the Khazar General faster than crypto miners can purchase graphics cards. And that meant I could complete the quest for enough attack experience to launch me from 1 all the way to 48. At this stage though, I didn't have enough points to unlock the Strenuous Strength skill. However, there was a pending update to refund some points as Jagex were reducing the skill prices. So I set to hold out a little longer. As a result, I crafted some more runes and made my way back to Lava Dragons in search for that essential kit and their bones. and there we got our first essential upgrade, the rune cutter chilled. From here, I was going to cash in some of those bones at the Chaos Altar. The experience from the Chaos Altar with the 8x multiply is actually insane. Using just a few bones, I got all my protection prayers. When I returned to Lava Dragons, though, I ran into a little bit of an issue. Every world was full of people, and from here came the moment where I had to teach a lower level person just how the wilderness works. So I smacked him with a frisky fireball. And with only about an hour and a half left, I got my rune longsword. I then ran to the altar, and well, I got 46 prayer. Now, the points have been refunded, it was time to unlock strength, and I need to get as much experience as possible. This meant waterfall quest. It sent me flying all the way to 56 attack and 50 strength. Now, we have just an hour left on the clock to prepare and beat Lilratbags. This last hour was frantic. I wanted several items still, and with my leftover points, I actually had the ability to unlock ancient magics. However, there were two things stopping me. Number one, I needed money to get runes and food for the fight, and two, the ancient staff cost 80k. My only hope was to get lucky at Lara for Dragons with some Raj drops or the armor I need. Unfortunately, I was here down to 20 minutes remaining, and I didn't get any of the drops I needed. It was now time to run around frantically to get food, runes, and armor. For food, I went to Brimhaven and I tried buying Kara Bombs, but they were sold out in every world I tried, and I was tight for time, so I had to settle for a banquet of seafood delicacies. I then ran around the countryside getting armor. I got an adamant chainmail, adamant medium helm, and mithril legs. I would have gotten adamant legs again. Everything was sold out. With that done, my 4 hours are up. It was time for the fight.
Should we do some revealing?
The grand reveal, I reckon weapon first.
Straight in.
Straight in.
No messing about. Straight for the big one. I still have that.
I have a rune longsword.
Okay. It's that. Oh, you know what? We've not done the combat level.
Oh, yeah, the combat level. Where isn't the gap?
2, 1. Oh, have you looked?
I looked. I couldn't help myself. One. I was excited.
Same level. Okay, that's worrying. Okay, so I will go helm.
Boom. All right, next up, shield.
Oh, not this thing. Same level now. I hope that rune simmies. I hope that rune longsword is just rubbish.
Body? Ooh.
You're looking tanky.
I beefed up a bit.
I just need my double range unlock, and I feel so much better. You're definitely, look, this is definitely going to be close, isn't it? Rune kite, where'd you get your rune kite?
Lava Dragons.
Okay.
I spent a very long time at Lava Dragons.
And get PK'd?
No, but I had to assert dominance on one low-level guy that was trying to steal my spot.
Felt good about myself. Didn't win the last battle, but this guy in the wilderness kicked his ass.
Yeah, he was a level 20, and I just hit him with the old fire bolts. He ran like a bitch. And then I said, my spot. Shall we get started? Yeah. Time to duel.
get more damage the lower my health is. So I don't want to play it too safe, but equally don't want to get stuck out.
Out.
You out? Oh, I've got like loads left. I've got 15 left. Seemed a lot closer than that, didn't it? Maybe that's the food that's helping that much. Mm. Like when you first switched to magic there, you were kicking my ass. Big
I
time.
I know. And that is a loss.
No, I don't think that's going to last though somehow. You have literally pulled it right back. I think your food probably let you down a little bit.
It is a considered valuable. Yes, I want to cast alchemy on it.